for households. And let me tell you, brothers and sisters, the last country poverty survey indicated that 28% of our population are below the poverty line. And we understand that because of COVID, an additional 24% of our population has now been affected. It is possible that more than 50% of our population is now below the poverty line. And if 50% of your population is now struggling, what do you do? Do you build roads? Do you pour concrete? Or do you ensure that your people have food to eat? Do you ensure that they have shelter in place? What do you do? My friends, I came into politics because I care about the social infrastructure of our people. I am concerned about our children. I am concerned about our senior people, some of whom live alone. I am concerned about our children who are having a difficult time, and the young men on the block who are struggling. It is for that reason that I entered politics. I am not in politics to build highways and to build buildings. I understand that there may be broken buildings and there are broken roads, but more importantly, we have broken lives. Instant, we shall have need to be repaired. And for that reason, tonight, I am asking you to revisit your decision, not to vote for concrete, but to vote for the establishment and the repairs of lives in Castro Southeast. We need to give a little more caring to our people. Because if your people are not there, the roads will make no sense. If you do not have a strong and caring population, the buildings and the schools will make no sense. According to the Chilean program, Chile Sise Contigo, or Chile Grows With You, the president of Chile decided that she would not allow the country to develop without investing in the people. Because she said, what is a developed Chile without a prepared people? We are developing St. Lucia for the people, and therefore the people must be prepared to embrace a developed country. It is for this reason that all the development that has taken place over the years have left a lot of our population behind. Our people are behind. Just imagine that we are building four lanes highway up to Grozile, and there are still people without flushing toilets. There are some people in their homes would not withstand the category 1 hurricane because we saw what happened. And even after hurricane passed, so many of our people are suffering. But what happened? There was a distress fund set up in the estimates of expenditure so that when somebody suffers loss, they can receive some support. Alan Shastner removed it, and he said people who own homes should have house insurance. Alan Shastner doesn't even understand what it is to be a St. Lucian. Alan Shastner doesn't even understand that insurances do not insure plywood houses. He doesn't know that. And therefore, he removed the distress fund, and he decided, or in his, every St. Lucian should have home insurance. My friends, some people cannot even provide their daily meals. How can they afford the premium for house insurance? But also, we had the STEP program. We had a nice program coming for our people. We had the Kumese FDC program. We had the home. And what happened? These programs were targeting ordinary St. Lucians. And for 25 years in government, I can tell you, anytime it has to be about investing money is in poor people. Some people find it too much money.